In this video, I'm going to show you how to repair torn drywall paper. Okay, who's had a drywall repair that looked similar to this? You're doing a renovation and you've got some damaged drywall paper. Your first instinct is let's cover it in mud and so we can get this thing finished. But I want to show you one thing that you need to do before you put that mud compound on torn drywall paper. During a recent bathroom remodel, we took off the vanity and the backsplash, and this is a result of what we had. Now, the first step you want to do is get rid of any loose material and edges, caulk edges, anything like that. On the paper, we want to get rid of any of the bubbles or torn edges that may cause a problem in the future. And to do that, we take just a flat putty knife or razor blade or anything like that, and just kind of, you see how I'm removing the paper here, scrape the edges, get all that loose stuff gone. Get all that down to a somewhat manageable working surface. I mean, this was, you know, this tore down, I mean, all the way through the layers of paper here. So I'm just trying to get that big stuff out of here, get all that down to where we can work with it. Now I'm taking some 220 grit sandpaper and I'm going over the torn edges of the paper and the fuzzies. I want to get that stuff down, get it removed. You'll see here that the sandpaper actually removes all that little debris off of my working surface. I want this surface to be as smooth as I possibly can get it, and this sandpaper gets it to where I need it to be. So let's pause here for a minute. So now you're thinking, okay, we just need to put our mud over this and this will be an easy repair. Gosh, I'm so glad I watched this video. No, we do not put mud directly over exposed sheetrock or drywall paper. That is a big no-no. You will end up with what they call blisters. And trust me, I've seen it happen more than once. It's a stupid, easy thing to avoid. I've done it myself. I mean, I'm gonna be honest with you, we all learn. I've done this myself. Watch what I do next. This is how you keep that stuff from blistering and lay that paper down perfect. That's right. I use the Zinsser Ben shellac-based primer. This primer actually penetrates the paper, draws it back into itself, and dries to a nice, hard substrate mimicking the sheetrock, the original sheetrock itself. This will also prevent any bleed throughs. It will prevent any bubbling because it's shellac based. The next water based product, i.e. the mud and or the paint, will not penetrate into the paper causing it to bubble again. It's a good, nice base to work with. I love this stuff. It's my go-to. Zinsser also makes a product called Guards, which does the same thing, but it's the exact same thing. And my local big box store doesn't offer the Guards, and I have this on hand, and it works the exact same way. So check that out. That's the key. I have done mud projects before where I have mudded over top of the paper, and it is a miserable time trying to deal with the bubbles and the stuff that shows through. Why fight it? You can take this stuff, you can prime the whole wall with it if you need to. It prevents bleed through and it will make that paper, you know, draw back into itself and create a nice substrate for you to work with and paint on top of and mud on top of. This is the biggest key to doing this kind of repair. Once the Zinsser Ben has dried, which is usually about 15 minutes, you can add your pre-mixed or mixed drywall compound to the wall. I used a mixed 20-minute drywall compound here. You mix it yourself with a little bit of water, and usually in about 20 minutes you can begin working the mud with sandpaper. Just make sure you get it all nice and smooth here. You can see I'm adding it smooth, and then we're going to start the sanding process and get all those ridges out and get this thing ready for our first layer of paint and or primer. I'm using a 100 grit sanding paper here to knock down the ridges. That's what I have in my arsenal, and it's usually the quickest, and I have it on a sanding block that usually goes on a paint stick or a pole or something like that. I just use it by hand here. You can see it's making quick work of the ridges and or the lines. So just use that to get down to your smooth, nice smooth finish. Now, I know some people watching are going to notice the joint compound that I have on the electrical cover, and they're going to think, man, that seems kind of sloppy. Well, let me explain. I would much rather clean joint compound off of a plastic cover than I would to have to dig it out of the wall or remove it from the actual, you know, device itself. So I just left the cover on here to kind of give me an edge to work up to without causing too much trouble. When I was adding the mud, I do remove it later once it starts, you know, when I get into the sanding a little further and painting and all that good stuff. I just wanted to clarify that because I know some people are going to hate that I left that cover on there. But in this particular situation, it actually helped me. It kind of gave me a little bit of a guide and helped me keep it a little cleaner on the finished piece. Again, this stuff's water soluble. I literally took a rag and wiped it off. Another bit of information here, you may notice that I'm sanding a lot more. Typically drywall compound, you know, sands really quickly with 100 grit, and this is sanding pretty quick too. However, with a 20 minute compound, you're using, the reason it's a 20 minute compound, it has some additives in there, which makes this a little more dense product than the average just lightweight compound. A lightweight compound would have worked fine here, and it would have dried and it would have sanded super quick. I just wanted to use the 20 minute mud so I could get right back to work with it. So just keep that in mind. The quick dry products have additives in there that help bind and help dry quicker, but it also makes it a little denser and harder to sand. So that's why you're seeing me sand quite as much as I'm doing. Once you finish sanding, you should end up with a smooth product like this. It should be ready for your paint. And then when we all got it all said and done, it was a smooth wall and a nice bathroom remodel with, you know, that ended up looking really good. It's a simple, easy fix. Just make sure you use the right products. Don't mud over the brown paper on sheetrock and you should be fine. If you like this video, make sure you check out this video here in the corner. And make sure you hit the subscribe button. See you next time.